Today, we're gonna build a home status shortcut. Now, when I run this, this shortcut is gonna check the status of my HomeKit smart home, and it's gonna report back to me if there's anything that, you know, I might wanna know, like if I left any windows open, maybe if the front door is unlocked, or if I left the garage door open.
Okay, Shane, the front door is unlocked. The back door is unlocked.
This is actually very easy to do and it's highly customizable. And be sure to stick around to the end because I'm gonna give you even more fun ideas and ways you can utilize this for your specific smart home setup. Let's go. Yo, what's going on? Thank you so much for joining me today. My name is Shane, and this channel is all about building an easy smart home using Apple's HomeKit platform with new videos published every Sunday. So before we get started, if you are completely new to Siri shortcuts and automations and want a good breakdown of what all this means and how it all works, then I would recommend checking out this intro video that I did right up here. It covers all the basics and should give you, a really good foundation of kind of what we're doing here. But otherwise, we're gonna have some fun today with Siri shortcuts. We're gonna keep everything real easy still, and we're gonna do that by actually using variables with the shortcut that we're about to set up. Now, I know that sounds kind of scary, but I promise you, it really isn't once you understand the concept. So in computer programming, variables are simply used to store information. They can be changed and can be referenced by that computer program, or in our case, a Siri shortcut. Today, essentially, we're gonna get some information about our HomeKit home, add that information to a variable, and then use that variable in some sort of notification or prompt to show us all the information that we might want to know about our home. Again, this is all highly customizable and there are many ways that you can take it even further if you want, which I will discuss briefly at the end of this video. All right, and let's go ahead and just jump right in. I'm going to open up the Shortcuts app and the first thing we need to do is just create a new shortcut and we're going to look for an if statement. So we're gonna be using a lot of if statements today. This is one of my favorite things in shortcuts. I use these all the time. So we're gonna drag that over here and we're gonna look for, tap the input, and then we're gonna choose select a home accessory. And we need to set this step up for pretty much any accessory where we wanna get the status of. Okay, so I'm gonna start with, let's just start with my front door lock. Okay, and if the front door, and now we need to choose, I want to look for the lock mechanism state. So it's going to be that one. And then I'm going to choose, you can choose is or is not. I'm actually going to choose is not because your lock could actually be jammed too. So I'd like to know if it's jammed or if it's open. If the front door lock is not locked, so that means if it's either open or it's jammed, I want to know about it. So now I'm going to look for text. I'm going to pull text over here. And we're just going to simply say the front door is unlocked. Okay. All right. So now if I play this, you're going to see that no information actually passes through because my front door is in fact locked right now. But let me go and unlock that front door real quick. So front door is unlocking. All right, I heard the front door unlocked. All right, now let's try to run this. All right, and you can see the front door is unlocked. So it passes that text through because, and I notice I've got a typo here. Why don't y'all tell me I had a typo? All right. Probably won't be the last one today. So the front door is unlocked. So now that the front door is actually unlocked, it passes that text through in my shortcut. And you can see that here. So right now, it doesn't do anything with this text. We need to add this to a variable. And this is where a variable comes in. So over here, I'm going to search for variable. And you can see a few options here. So I'm going to choose add to variable. Okay. I'm going to put it right underneath my text. And it automatically grabs that text and fills it in there since I put it right after it. It kind of knew what I wanted to do, and you can see that little line right there indicates that. Okay, so it's gonna add that text to a new variable because I don't have one yet. I'm going to create one. And what we're going to do is basically create a variable. We're going to use this variable throughout the shortcut. So we're going to get the information from each of our accessories. And as we go, we're going to add that information to our variable each time, to the same variable. And then all we have to do is just call up that same variable at the end, and we can kind of do what we want with it. So we're going to call this home status. So again, this is my variable, and my variable is called home status, okay? Otherwise, if my front door is locked, I really don't care. I don't need to see that. If you do want some information, you want that included in your report or however you do it, you can basically do the same thing here, except add it to the otherwise section and say your front door is locked. So you can definitely do that if you want. I'm actually just gonna delete the otherwise because I don't need it. Now I'm gonna do the same thing for kind of each one of my accessories. So I'm gonna do another if statement. I'm gonna bring it over here. I need to clear that, and I want if select a home accessory, and let's see, let's do my back door lock, because I need to know my back door lock also. Lock mechanism current state is not locked. So if it's not locked, again, we're going to look for text. Back door is unlocked. And technically, if it's jammed, it'll also tell me that it's unlocked, but I'm okay with that. Essentially, it's telling me that it's not locked, which is what I want. Now we're gonna do the same thing. We're going to add this text piece to our same variable. Make sure you spell it right. Something I have to check for because I misspell stuff all the time. Okay, so this is happening again. Now it's gonna check for the back door. And if it's locked, it's going to do nothing. If it's not locked, it's going to add this to our little variable there. Okay, again, I can delete the otherwise part because we don't need that. Now let's play this and see how it does. You can see it kind of going through. The front door is unlocked, okay? And you can actually see everything that's in that variable by swiping. Okay, so the back door is unlocked. That got passed through also. So far, so good. I'm going to go ahead and just quickly add a couple more accessories here. I'm going to just repeat this process. New if statement. Definitely want my garage door in there. Garage door. If the current garage door state is open, text. Garage door is open. Add to variable. One thing I like about this shortcut, one of the reasons why I kind of set this up is because I actually have a back door that we have a screen door in there, like a storm door. And sometimes, you know, the door is open and I might run my good night scene, which actually locks all the doors. So it could technically lock, and this has happened, my back door lock might lock and the door is not even closed. So by using something like this, I'll know if my doors are actually closed. So I'm going to do one for my back door and actually, so I can actually know if my door itself is, you know, is closed. So let's clear this. We're going to look for select home accessory, back door. So if the back contact sensor is open, see, one thing you can do, you can actually click on these right here and duplicate actions. If you didn't know that, that's pretty handy. Then you can kind of click and move them around. So I'm gonna pull that under there and I'm just gonna change this. The back door is open. Add that to our variable. All right, so you're starting to get the idea here. I'm just going through doing these if statements and then adding to the variable if it registers anything. You can add your security system. You can see if, you know, your security system is armed. Check any doors, window sensors, anything in your HomeKit smart home, you can add to this. Anything that's exposed to HomeKit, you can do this for. For the sake of this demonstration, I'm gonna keep it moving. Remember, if everything is locked and secure, nothing will actually pass through, okay? So I wanna kinda utilize that. So what I'm gonna do here, I'm gonna do yet another if statement, okay? And I'm gonna drag this over here to the bottom. All right, and I'm gonna clear this. basically, there could potentially be nothing in our variable at this point. So if the doors are closed, the garage door is shut, if the locks are locked, then there will be no information in our variable. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to say if home status does not have any value, okay, I'm going to create another text, and now I'm gonna give it some value. So if it doesn't have anything, I'm gonna give it some value. We're gonna look for a text again, kind of like we did before. I'm just gonna write everything is secure. Okay, good enough. And we're actually gonna add that to our home status variable. Now again, it's only going to add that to my variable if there's nothing already in there. Otherwise, you know, it's not going to do anything. All right, so good to go. Now we're simply going to look for a notification. Show notification. Remove this. And you can select your home status. You see that right there? That is our variable. You have some more options here. You can choose to play a sound. You can add attachment. I'm actually going to clear that. And now let's give this a test and see how it goes. If I play it, front door is unlocked, the back door is unlocked, and there's actually more. You can see there, it only gives us so much in our notification. If we tap it, you can see even more information there. And that is pretty much it. So we can name this home status. We can choose, I like to choose this and then our little home icon here. Kind of makes it look like HomeKit to me. You can add this to your home screen. So let's go ahead and tap that. Now check this out. Done, done. Now if I go to my home screen, you can see right here, home status. If I tap that, boom, the front door is unlocked, the back door is unlocked. Open it up to see even more information if there is any. Now just to show you, let me secure everything. I'm gonna lock my back door, lock my front door. What else is there? My garage door needs to be closed. And that should do it. Now let's run it again and we should get that notification that says everything is good to go. Run that home status. Everything is secure. So you can see there, works like a charm. So there you go, I told you that was gonna be pretty easy, but we can even do more with this and make it better if you want. Again, this is gonna really depend on how you wanna use this. So this is utilizing the notification action, and that is good for something like this. If you wanna run it manually, it works. It's also good for automations. So you can set that to run, you know, at a certain time of day, every day if you want. You can set it to run when you leave home, different things like that. But it doesn't work so well if you want to use it on like your HomePod. You can actually set up something to run on your HomePods just to shout off, hey, what's my home status or something like that. Let me show you how I would approach that. Really, I would just change, instead of using show notification here, let's choose show result. And let's remove that and we can choose home status. Now it's going to look a little bit different. We'll play it and everything is secure again. So it actually looks very similar here and we get a done button. So it's a little different here. Again, this method doesn't work as good for automations, but this, I actually like this method a little bit better if you're doing like from your HomePod or if you're running it manually. Let me open up, let me unlock that front door. Now let's go back to our home screen and run it real quick. And you can see it says the front door is unlocked. And this will also work with our HomePod. Hey Siri, home status. HomePod over here.
The front door is unlocked. The back door is unlocked.
Boom, how cool is this? You can run this from your HomePods in your house. But what good is all this information if you can't do anything? Let's take it even further and let's go ahead and give us some options, like maybe lock up all the doors or close the garage. It's pretty easy to do also. Open my shortcut back up. So again, here in the end, this is what's cool about using variables. It makes it very easy to kind of just call on this information. So I'm just going to remove that show result action there at the very end. And instead, I'm going to do choose from menu. Right here. Pull this at the very end. And what you can do here is you can actually add that home status variable as the prompt in the choose from menu. Okay. Now, option one right here can be, I don't know, let's say lock all doors. Option two can be close the garage. We can add another one. Option three could be, I don't know, arm the security system. All right. Now you have these options. If you haven't used choose from menu before, it's kind of similar to the if statement. Now we just run. We look for our home accessories and we'll choose Control Whatley Home. Lock all doors. I can set my scenes and accessories. So I'm going to look for front door and back door. Choose next. I'm going to lock both of those. Choose done. There you go. So if I choose lock all doors, it'll do that. Close the garage. Again, we're going to look for that home. Control Whatley Home, close the garage, and there's my garage door. Choose next. Again, make sure it's closed. You can open or close. I do want it closed. And arm the security system. Once again, look for home, scenes and accessories. And like if you have maybe a scene that does all this stuff already, like locks the doors and shuts the garage, arms the security system, you could add the scene right here in one of these menus. You can really kind of get creative and do a lot with this. So security system, next. I want to arm that. Choose done. All right, and so now if I run this, let's try it again. The front door is unlocked. Lock all doors, close the garage, arm the security system. I now have options that I can do from this little thing. Again, this method doesn't work very well with automations because your phone has to be unlocked for this show result to work, or choose from menu, I think. But this works really good for running manually. Let me unlock my back door just to show you what it looks like with multiple accessories. Shoot, I'll go ahead and even I'll open my garage for you too. Let's go ahead and open that. Now I gotta actually wait for my garage door to open, which takes a second, and then we'll run this again and you'll see how this works with choose from menu. Okay, play. Boom, look at that. Shows the front door is unlocked, the back door is unlocked, the garage door is open. I can choose what I want to do. Let's go ahead and close the garage. Close the garage. I can actually hear it closing right now. I pull out the home app and you can see it's closing right now as we speak. So that ran as a part of this shortcut. So these are great for like widgets. Put it on your home screen. Again, like I can just run this anytime I want right here. Tells me the front door is unlocked, back door is unlocked. Again, choose from menu even works on the HomePod. Let me see if I can get Siri to work real quick on this. Hey Siri, home status.
Okay, Shane. The front door is unlocked. The back door is unlocked. Lock all doors, close the garage, or arm the security system.
Lock all doors.
One sec. That's done, Shane.
How cool is that? I hear all my doors locking. I just did that from my HomePod. So you can see this is really versatile. You can get creative and figure out a way to use this, use these variables and stuff with your shortcuts and your smart home to fit your needs, whatever that might look like. If you want to go a little further down this rabbit hole and check out how you can actually get custom notifications when your door has been left open for too long, for example, check out this video right up here. If you got something out of this video, hit that like button. That does help out the channel. Subscribe for new HomeKit videos every Sunday. Good luck with your smart home setup, and until next time, we'll see you later.